Inside this 270,000-gallon tank live over 600 animals, ranging from sharks to tiny fish. National Aquarium in Baltimore brings in around 1.3 million visitors a year. But what guests don't always see is what goes on to keep all these animals alive. From turning salt pellets into seawater, to training the fish.
I kind of have to be a Jedi with this.
To scrubbing the unique 3,000-piece replicated coral reef system, National Aquarium's total operations add up to $45 million a year. The Blacktip Reef exhibit was renovated with $12.5 million, and $800,000 went to this entire replicated coral reef system. So maintaining this expensive habitat is a top priority. Three times a week, scuba-certified divers gear up to clean the exhibit.
In total, when you look at this equipment and you add a mask to it, it can be about $2,000 to outfit one diver.
These acrylic pads, originally used for car washing, also work on the viewing windows.
Since we're very buoyant in the water, we use suction cups to help keep us anchored to the window. One of the most time-consuming tasks we have is hand scrubbing because the algal growth is regularly occurring. We have these larger utility brushes that are good for an overall area. We have these awesome grout brushes that really help into getting into some of those smaller areas and better on more textured areas. And these little toothbrushes are really great when it comes to brushing some of those more detailing areas.
This cast coral cost anywhere from $25 to $1,700 a piece. Animals are used to the divers, like Zoe, who gets close because she's curious about the bubbles they create. But not all animals in the exhibit are considered safe, so the divers have to constantly be aware of their surroundings.
We do have some hazardous animals in there with spines.
And dive cleaning is just the first step in quality control when it comes to the water.
The next line of defense behind us is the water filtration systems.
So all the animals in Blacktip Reef are completely relying on this set of equipment that we're looking at.
This exhibit's life support system is monitored 24/7.
So we actually have two people at all times, any given night.
First, this denitrification system helps remove toxic nitrates, which creates healthy living conditions and mitigates algae growth. A second filter backwash process takes water from the exhibit, filters it, before pumping it back. This system prevents roughly 2.7 million gallons of water from being discarded annually.
That's a lot of seawater that we would be throwing away. It's very expensive.
With this system, the aquarium only needs to replace a portion of Blacktip Reef's water at a time. And instead of sourcing seawater, the aquarium makes its own with these 2,500-pound salt pellets.
The animals that we are supporting in these habitats have learned to survive in that vast, full complement of seawater ions. If any of them are missing, it can throw that internal process off balance.
It takes eight of these pellets to create a batch of replicated seawater, which can be used for all the aquarium's seawater exhibits. And thanks to Blacktip Reef's filtration systems, the exhibit only needs around 20,000 gallons of new seawater every 3 months, saving the aquarium roughly $450,000 a year. To fill this tank with living animals, the aquarium had a budget of about $325,000. Some of these fish cost nearly $8,500 each to ship from Australia. But in the past, some of the predator species have eaten the smaller fish, which is why it is crucial to keep the apex predators well-fed.
Pepe is our black-blotched stingray.
And trained.
He is quite rambunctious. Oh, Pepe.
The exhibit spends about $21,000 a year on feed for the animals. Feed varies by species, ranging from mackerel and squid to krill and pellets. And in total, the Blacktip Reef goes through about 6,700 pounds of feed in a year. The eight sharks in this exhibit eat 30% of that.
We're gonna be working with Zuri today, so she'll be receiving her food, her diet, during the training session.
This buoy guides Zuri the shark on where to swim. And this orange target signals where to stay.
It took Zuri a few months to learn to target and to really follow the target.
Nice.
She was very curious about the platform, but staying nice and still and calm is a bit of a challenge for her.
Aquarists also use feeding sessions to train an animal for routine health checks. Other animals that go through training sessions include the pack of Blacktip Reef sharks Australian whiptail rays, Zoe, the other zebra shark, and Bertha, the Queensland grouper. She's still working on it.
We use positive reinforcement training in order to help us do as many things with them as we can with as little stress as possible. The more stress an animal experiences, of course, the more negative health ramifications that can have.
Predators get fed separately from the rest of the fish. And during feeding, aquarists will monitor for unusual behavior of all 630 animals.
There is the chance that we would need to move a fish to a different exhibit. For instance, if they are not getting along with another fish in the habitat, we might need to separate the two fish, or perhaps they are eating things that might cause them harm.
Some animals, like Duncan the pufferfish, were relocated because they were eating the coral, which didn't cause any medical issues, but did damage the reef. Duncan will likely be replaced with other creatures, which will continue the aquarium's conservation and education initiatives.
Adding animals into the Blacktip Reef habitat is something that typically takes place about once a year.
The National Aquarium generated $430 million in tourist-related economic impact in 2022, and new residents could bring in more guests.
Guests who have come to know the Blacktip Reef habitat for a long time knew Calypso, who was a green sea turtle. Although we were devastated to lose her in 2020, we are excited at the prospect of hopefully being able to add another green sea turtle into Blacktip Reef in the future.